Well, author, lecturer, educator Daniel Hudon is coming to the Adam Shore branch of the Thomas Crane Public Library on Monday, April the 30th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. to talk about his latest book. It's Brief Eulogies for Lost Animals, but he's here right now to give us a little preview about himself and about this particular work. So, Daniel, first of all, nice to meet you, and thanks for coming to our studios.
Thanks so much for having me, Joe. Great to be here.
Pleasure. This is going to be a chat and a presentation about your latest work of extinct species, I guess.
That's true. Yeah. That's right. Yeah. People know about the passenger pigeon and the dodo, but not the 900 other species that have gone extinct in the last 400 or 500 years.
900?
900.
Wow, okay.
That's right.
Tell us a little bit about yourself first, if you could.
So I'm a part-time lecturer in Boston at Northeastern University and Boston University.
Okay.
My background is actually astronomy.
Of course it is.
Yeah.
So why wouldn't it be, right?
That's right. Yeah. So I teach some astronomy now, and I teach calculus, and I am involved in the physics course now, too.
All right.
Yeah.
So how did this
book come out?
Interest yeah. in extinct species come about?
Yeah. I used to be involved in a team-taught course on biodiversity. So I was in a program at Boston University, and our course was Biodiversity Causes and Consequences. And so it was it was my task to give the two lectures on the history of life on Earth and the fossil evidence for biodiversity.
Wow.
So when you start exploring the history of life on Earth, you find out about these previous mass extinctions. And so I wanted to bring it up to date, essentially, and find out, you know, how biodiversity is faring. And then I started finding out that the extinction rate today is much higher than that's recorded in the fossil record or measured in the fossil record.
Okay, so the rate of species that are going extinct is
true.
Higher now than it was.
That's
okay.
Right.
And
yeah.
Did you determine a cause for that?
The main causes for extinction are over the eons, species have gone extinct because of environmental changes, mm-hmm. but now the environment is changing too quickly for a species to adapt, and it's the main causes are habitat loss, introduction of invasive species, you know, rats and other creatures like that, mm-hmm. Pollution, and overhunting, over harvesting. But the next big driver, of course, will be climate change.
Okay.
Yeah.
And do you talk at all in the book about the reasons for that acceleration, I guess?
It's not so much about that. No,
okay.
it's about sort of honoring these animals that,
okay.
that you know, they're just another branch in the tree of life like we are.
Mm-hmm.
And so they've essentially fought their battles to overcome environmental changes and thrive the way we have, and you know, our sort of heavy footprint on the environment has caused them to dwindle to the point of extinction.
Mm-hmm. So you're trying to, as it says in the title, eulogize them, right? Catalog them, give them some presents.
Right. So it's about it's a bit about celebration, a bit about memorialization, and just raising awareness that these species mattered.
Mm-hmm. You know? Why do this, Daniel? What's the goal for this project?
I'm worried about biodiversity. I'm worried about the long term. You know, some of the higher profile animals get a lot of attention, like the lions and tigers and whatnot. But I think you can just pick your place around the world where animals are facing many challenges and pressures from, mm-hmm. from human influence.
Mm-hmm. To talk about the book itself, is it written in story form? Is it kind of a documentary format? Is it just a catalog format?
Yeah, it's kind of a story form.
Okay.
I've always been attracted to very short prose pieces.
Okay.
And I was kind of inspired by a couple of coffee table books, but I didn't want to redo what they had done.
Right.
And so I just wanted to just try to see if I could catch a glimpse or expose a glimpse. Catch a moment of some of these species, some of these animals, you know, just doing what they're doing, like looking for a mate, hiding out from a storm, mm. Those sort of things, just to bring them some element of liveliness, mm. really.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Are there pictures in the book at all?
There are not pictures.
No.
Maybe a future version will have them. Yeah.
Okay. All right. What was involved for researching this project? How did you actually obtain this information?
I tried to go to original sources whenever I could. You know, so the research papers from over the years, the International Union for the Conservation of Nature catalogs endangered species, and it has a category for extinct species.
Mm.
So I'd go there and see what they had and what references they had, and then try to dig in and see what I could find. Often there is very little written about a species, so I was grasping at whatever I could get, like a quote from a scientist.
Yeah.
Sometimes even a line of poetry that would animate it somehow.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. Okay. What would you say is the most recent extinct species in our region here in the Northeast?
Oh, in the Northeast, let's see. For sure, it should be the heath hen that went out on last thrived in Martha's Vineyard.
Oh,
yeah, Booming Ben, I think is the last one was called around 1929, 1930.
Okay, so it all. I mean, we're talking reptiles, amphibians, mammals. Is it a cross section of?
Yeah, those are all in the book. Okay. Yeah, I didn't want to just focus on the most familiar.
Right.
And so I did find a worm that had gone extinct.
Okay.
I found several insects. There are butterflies. There are moths.
Huh.
As well as frogs and various mammals and birds. Yeah.
So who do you think would find this interesting, Daniel? You know, who are you trying to appeal to?
In part, it's to the choir, you know, people that read natural history, people that read about conservation, people that are interested in the environment, but also readers of poetry and literature would find it interesting too because of the style of the book.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, very good. This is your second book, is that
this
right?
This is my second book, that's right.
What was the first one?
The first book was called The Bluffer's Guide to the Cosmos.
Aha.
So it's in the Bluffer's Guide series from the UK.
Okay.
And you're supposed to be able to read a few pages, and I think you can read a few pages and sound like an expert.
Aha,
and bluff your way on the Big Bang or what have you.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's more in line, obviously, with your day job, if you will.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But does this this particular work, this new work, represent a different direction you'd like to go in the future?
Truly, yeah. Yeah, I'm, you know, I've, as I started to find out more about just species loss and endangered species, I just, you know, became more interested in it, and yeah, I'd like to be more involved in conservation and get involved in volunteer projects and citizen science and whatnot.
Okay.
Yeah, I've kind of been an armchair involved in an armchair way so far, and I'd like to be
more active, roll
up my sleeves and get my hands dirty.
Okay.
Yeah.
Talk about your presentation here on the 30th of April. It's from 7 to 8:30, and again, it's at the Adam Shore branch of the Thomas Crane Library. So what will be happening that night?
So I'm going to talk a little bit about extinction and how the problem of extinction became into awareness.
Mm.
For a long time, no one thought that species could go extinct. And so that was an idea that you know has not really been in been known for so long. Like in the middle of the 1800s, people finally realized, oh yeah, species can go extinct.
Okay.
You know. So I'll talk a little about extinction and how we know what we know about the biodiversity crisis, and then I'll talk about various parts of the book. You know how I presented the book, the style. It's actually organized geographically.
Oh.
Yeah, and then I have some short, so I'll do some readings from different sections of the book.
Okay.
And then I actually made some short videos of the of some of the stories as well, and so I'll present a few of those.
Oh, that you produce yourself?
That's right.
You narrating them?
Yeah.
Oh, very good. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we look forward to that. Again, it is Monday, April 30th, 7 to 8:30 p.m. Brief Eulogies for Lost Animals, Daniel Hudon presenting. And if Dana, thank you so much for coming by, and good luck with your work in the future.
Thanks very much, Joe.
You're very welcome. If you'd like to get more information about this or any of the programs at the library, go to their website. It's thomascranelibrary.org.